Hola, mi nombre es Elizabeth Jackson y estás viendo the IUS Horizon broadcast.
It's easy to report the bad, but I'm out to find the good in people.
I love writing and I love sports.
I'm in journalism to unite the world as one.
Reporting and sharing the truth makes the world a better place.
Because it takes integrity.
Curiosity. I want to know everything.
News is about connecting with the viewers and delivering the facts.
It's my passion in life.
I love a good investigation.
I give my viewers the satisfaction they deserve. We are The Horizon.
Good afternoon and welcome to The Horizon Newscast for the week of March 14, 2011. I'm CJ Daniels. Our stories begin with a recap of the men's and women's basketball team's road to the NAIA National Championship. New Albany Mayor Doug England honored the teams during a special celebration. Our own Ashley Agnew found out why this was a great honor.
Players, coaches, fans, and other community members gathered for a send-off celebration in honor of the IUS men's and women's basketball teams.
Well, it's great that the city was here to honor these athletes. They've done a great job all year, the men's and women's team, and it means a lot to our department to have the mayor and some city officials and all of our city employees just kind of have a day to recognize these teams and their accomplishments. It really means a lot to them, and it means a lot to me, and we just can't thank them enough for all their support.
We've been saying that this is probably, if not the best, one of the best teams we've ever had. They set a school record for wins with 27. They're currently on a 16-game winning streak, which is also a school record. We've won 24 out of our last 25 games. I mean, this team has really been solid.
For the tournament, the women's team will travel to Sioux City, Iowa, and the men's team will travel to Point Lookout, Missouri. I talked with a couple of freshmen about their feelings on the first time heading to the tournament.
I'm real excited, man. All the people that's been to it, they told me about it, told me it was real fun up there, good atmosphere. I'm just trying to go up there and bring national championship home to IUS.
It's awesome. The whole experience has been fun. It's like, I've never done anything like this before. My high school team wasn't very good, so it's the first actual like big thing that I've got to experience, and it's just been fun all the way around.
At press time, the men's team fell to Iowa Wesleyan 86-75, and the women's team was defeated by Briarcliff 71-57.
From the City County Building in New Albany, this is Ashley Agnew, Horizon Newscast.
Thanks, IUS Athletics, for a terrific basketball season. Upcoming singer-songwriter Corey Brumback played a special performance at IUS. Nicolette Langdon caught up with Brumback to talk music as well as his inspiration for songs.
The SBC invited acoustic musician Corey Brumback to perform in the Commons.
Fade out of sight into the night. I'm gonna ride like a phantom.
His music is just very relaxing, and I thought it would be great. Like, it's almost like a cafe or coffee house type, just to bring him in, just to, you know, kind of relax, because I think it's going through midterms and everybody's getting antsy and anxious. So.
I spoke with Corey about the songs he writes and where he gets his inspiration to write them.
Everything, life, people, myself, my own struggles in life. I just write about it.
We really like him. They want me to bring him back, and actually Dr. Garvey Nix, who's the Vice Chancellor of Student Affairs, came over and said that administration is just really impressed with him and want to actually have him back on campus.
I personally liked it because I play guitar myself, and just the songs he played was my style, like the type of acoustic, kind of softer style.
Corey's music can be downloaded from www.mcbmusic.com and can be seen in several locations around the area.
We're playing at RERA on 4th Street tomorrow night, and we're playing a festival in Southern Indiana, the Maple Syrup Festival on Sunday. We play at Diamond Pub in St. Matthews every other Sunday night.
From the Commons, Nicolette Langdon, The Horizon Newscast.
With the economy in crisis and gas prices on the rise, reporter Annie Malka spoke with the IUS community about their spring break plans.
With the price of gas on the rise and spring break fast approaching, I set out to find whether the high price of gas would affect students' spring break plans.
My husband works full time, and we just never made any plans about going anywhere.
I just plan to go home and just relax at home this spring break.
I'm starting up a band
and with a bunch of my friends, and we're just going to try to jam and write all their stuff during spring break because we can actually all get together.
I'm going to, like Neil said, get that band together, start getting that going, writing stuff for them, hopefully get some material for that, and just, I was actually thinking about trying to plan a road trip, but with the gas prices how they are, I don't know if that's going to happen.
Annie Malka, The Horizon Newscast.
Two journalists took a trip of a lifetime across America, stopping at different mosques around the country. The pair made a special stop at IUS to talk about what it's like to be Muslim in America. Chrissy Taylor was on the scene to capture student reaction.
Aman Ali and Bassam Tariq joined the IUS library to talk about their 30 mosque in 30 days experience. During the Islam holy month of fasting and prayer, journalists Aman Ali and Bassam Tariq took a 30-day road trip across the United States, stopping each night in a different state for prayer and breakfast at a mosque.
We found out in New York that there is 163 mosques within a 10-mile radius of where I live. And we're like, oh man, that's awesome. Like, there's so many mosques in this area. And so one of us said to the other, like, wouldn't it be crazy in New York City, we went to a different mosque every day during Ramadan, just in New York.
Faith is something that's very personal. You know, I've always been proud of my identity and very comfortable with who I am. I think it just, one thing, it definitely made me appreciate, you know, not only being a Muslim, being American. I know it sounds very cliche, but those terms aren't contradictory towards one another. And I think that's one thing I really took from this.
The presentation served as a counter-narrative to the image of Muslims in America today. The trip was documented on their blog, 30mosques.com.
You know, I've actually been really concerned the last year or so with what I see as a really rising level of anti-Islamic, anti-Muslim rhetoric in the United States. To me, much more so than we saw in the immediate aftermath of 9/11.
I found it shocking how many, like, white Muslim people there are in the community, like, in America, I guess, and how there are full cultures of white American Muslims.
We're doing 30 states in 30 days again, because we felt we have only scratched the surface with all these great stories around the country. And so we're going to do 20 states that we didn't visit last year. And then we're going to, in 10 of those days, we're going to revisit some old states. Maybe go to a different city, maybe go to the same mosques.
This has been Christy Taylor, The Horizon Newscast.
Barnes & Noble is making changes again, this time to faculty book purchases. Annie Malka talks with the company and if the changes will have any effects on the students.
Listen up, IUS students. BarnesandNoble.com recently withdrew from its shop contracts. We found out what this means for the IUS and Barnes & Noble partnership.
Well, the press release actually only affects the procurement end of Indiana University. In no way whatsoever changes the in-store bookstore experience. We're still your first source for textbooks. We're still your source for all of your IU Southeast stuff.
These changes will affect the professors more than the students because the website they previously used to order books for students is now merging into the Barnes & Noble retail website.
When you go to One Star and click on View Textbooks, will they still be able to order them in that regard, even with the way that they're changing their website setup?
Absolutely. That won't change at all. So, in fact, I talked to Barnes & Noble earlier today just to review my notes. Right. And they had encouraged students to access their website through the OneStar portal. Where it may actually help students is this is another effort to try to manage and maybe even reduce costs, or it may be cost neutral. So in that regard, we'll still have the option to get competitive priced products from Barnes & Noble.
Annie Malka, Horizon Newscast.
Thank you for tuning in to the Horizon Newscast. We'll be off next week for the spring break holiday, so make sure you tune in on March 28th. Also, check out What's the Word, the link below the newscast. I'm CJ Daniels, wishing you all a safe and happy spring break.